Paint technology has made giant strides in the last few decades, and construction chemicals along with paint technology have been able to resolve so many endemic issues of construction, interiors and exteriors. We met up with Sujit Sinha, President, Paints Division, Grohr & Weil at his office in Mumbai to learn the latest developments in paints that real estate and urban infrastructure project managers and architects can put to good use in their projects. I started by asking him about how things have changed in the decorative and industrial paint sector.
Almost 39 years I have been in this paint industry. Oh. And I have seen the sea changes happening in the paint industry, the paint products per se. And last 10 years have been very huge in terms of the product portfolio change and the requirement change of the customers.
Okay.
Actually, if you see, there are two segments of paint industry. One is the decorative paint.
Correct.
Another is the industrial paints.
Correct.
From the decorative paint perspective, if you see, the total change has happened from distempers, cement paints to high performance emulsions.
That is from the 70s to, right?
From 80s to today.
Right.
And the total focus is on hygiene and safety today. And because of that, today's products, mainly for interiors, they have gone towards the health conscious, health shield products, wherein the products are safe even for children, even they can touch it, lick it, but it won't happen anything. So there is a sea change in the decorative business paint, and exterior paints also has gone a tremendous change from cement paint to high durable. 10 years, 15 years, now people are asking for 25 years.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very difficult for doing the painting when after the building is occupied for a multi-story building. So these are the requirement, and today most of the top companies are in the field with these products. And not only the product, but they are guaranteed product. They're giving guarantees because these products are tested by the international labs.
Okay, okay.
Like for bacterial, antibacterial products, there are 32 bacterias that they test that they don't grow on the paint.
Okay.
Similarly, for virus also, like influenza, H1N1 virus, these were common in the past. But now with the SARS-CoV-2 coming in, now the paint is also tested against SARS. And they have done modifications.
And how successful has that been?
Successful. The certificates have been in the market. Products are in the market. So those are the changes. The paint industry has been a dynamic industry.
Mm-hmm.
If you see in industrial also, because I have been handling industrial paint for many, many years now.
Okay.
See, from those low build products, synthetic enamels or normal, we have gone into high different chemistries today, like polysiloxane, like fluoropolymer based products, like solvent-free products, heavy-duty solvent-free products.
Mm-hmm.
Means from the thin multi-layer coating, three-coat, four-coat system, the shift has been towards the single-coat system. So that helps in faster turnaround of the painting because you have to apply only one coat instead of four. And then there is a safe also in terms of no delamination failure occurs when the layer is only one.
Oh, okay.
So these are many changes happen, and it will continue. I mean, the process is continuous.
I see. When you talk about, you know, the components of paints making it more safe, then it also would entail that there will be a lot of other products from, or rather other accessories also would be using the same kind of paints in real estate. For instance, varnishes, other kinds of paints which are
everything
used.
Everything comes under paint, you know, like
correct.
Varnish or today.
So it's not just interiors.
It's not interior. Exterior also like antifungal properties.
Yeah.
Today, paint company is giving guarantee of 15 years. So how they can give such guarantee unless you have got the composition, chemistry, proven chemistry.
Everything
tested.
Right.
Yeah. And it works. I live in a house which was painted, say, 2006. Exterior paint. And now we are thinking of doing the painting.
Wow.
So it's almost 15 years gone, and I see that my building every day. So it's is happening. I mean, it's a very dynamic situation, and it is going.
And so, how much is the lag between the technology available in the advanced world and India or any other third world? What's the lag? Is there a lag now?
No, I will say that India has got all the technologies which is available anywhere in the world.
Okay.
So, today Indian paint companies have enough technology, enough resources, and they are able to deliver them. So there is no lag.
Okay. Which essentially means that if real estate developers from abroad are coming in to India, they will not. They will be quite at home.
Of course, they will get every product they want.
I see.
See, there are many work going on which has not yet come out. There is a long-term R&D setup in the organized sector industry. They keep working on the product gaps that they have in India.
Mm-hmm.
The comparison is the global market. Like every product takes a very long time to develop. So the work is already on. Like if you see anti-fog paint lacquer.
Oh, okay.
Means if you apply that lacquer, the ice snow will not sit on it, it will flow down. So when you are making a house in a country where there is always sub-zero temperature, use those paints. It will help you to detach the ice from.
There is something on glass also, is it?
Yeah, glass, like aircraft. When the aircraft lands, there is snow, snowing. You need those lacquers on the glass, so that when snow falls on it, it slips down.
Oh, I see.
Those lacquers are there. Like a small thing, when you are in your toilet and your geyser is on, there's a lot of smoke, all your glasses become frosted.
Correct.
There is lacquer available which are called anti-frost.
Okay. But that you apply on the glass?
Glass. So the frost will not be sticking on it, it will just drop down like a water droplet. So these are the products available, research is going on, products are there, tested. Of course, bulk use will come later. That's why I'm saying there are a lot of work going on behind the scene for the specialized product future requirements.
So, if I ask you specifically, if there are three things that would be of you know interest for real estate project managers, what would they be in terms of developments in paints?
See, all
which
these
they should put into use in their new projects.
See, all these real estate developers, there are many now. You know, there are large size, small size, medium size.
Right.
Everybody is competing with each other, to be frank. Now, they all want their building to look different. Now, how a building will look different? One is your architectural feature, of course. And second, of course, the paint that is more visible. So, their demands come. Look, I want an antique finish in my one wall in the room, bedroom. So develop an antique finish for us. So you develop an antique finish. Somebody wants a two-tone finish. Somebody wants a designer, some kind of, say, texture.
Okay.
Special texture.
Correct.
Somebody has a preference for color, like one of the largest builder here in Mumbai, Hiranandani. They use one saffron color
as
their color patent.
Correct.
They use all their building with that. They don't use any other color.
Correct.
So all these preferences come. Then slowly, like in the flooring segment, so far we have been using tiles, but now people have started using the epoxy screed flooring, which is a self-leveling epoxy, which is a paint actually.
Okay.
And it doesn't have any joints. The tiles has a problem that joints, you will have dust collection, there could be leakage. You can use those self-leveling epoxies. They are as bright and skid-proof as any other.
And it's also durable?
Yeah, of course. It's very durable.
You can redo it, repair it
whenever you want. In fact, in the industrial segment, industrial floors, they do it. But slowly it is coming, like some of the building lobbies, you will find this kind of flooring.
Okay. Now, can you also tell us about the changing customer preferences for design and color? But before that, let me also ask you, is there an overlap between paints and other, you know, facets of interiors? For instance, earlier paints would only do about color. Now paints are also into waterproofing, into all kinds of other things. So what is the trend that you see and how do you explain it? Is it led by the customers or is it because new things are coming up out of innovation?
See, what happens is the construction quality many times is not at par with the requirement. That I will not say it is intentional, but because of the raw materials. Like sand, when you are building a constructing a building in the offshore, in the seashore areas where you don't have river sand.
Correct.
So you have to use sand
which is available,
which will have some salt, even if you wash it, screen it, some salt.
Okay.
Then humidity is always above 75%. So there is always a chance that you will have some effluences in some place, some dampness. But when you paint it, paint will not stick to your damp surface, it will peel off.
Yeah.
So a consumer was earlier in has to go to two agencies. One is the waterproofing agency, another is the painting agency. So unless waterproofing is done, painting won't be done.
Correct, correct.
So this all big companies have decided to take the waterproofing into the paint.
That has actually changed the market
whole
itself.
The whole thing has. It has made a revolutionary change,
right?
Because tomorrow, when there are two agencies working and there is a failure, both agencies will blame each other. ये आपका वाटर प्रूफिंग का केमिकल ठीक नहीं था, वो बोलेगा आपका पेंट में प्रॉब्लम है. बट टूडे वेन इट इज विद द सेम कंपनी, यू कैन नॉट ब्लेम. तो कस्टमर इज
अकाउंटेबिलिटी,
अकाउंटेबिलिटी हैज कम. वेन यू गो फॉर पेंटिंग, यू डू योर वाटर प्रूफिंग एंड देन पेंट. सो दैट हैज बिकम ए सिंगल विंडो काइंड ऑफ सॉल्यूशन दैट कस्टमर इज गेटिंग टूडे. And on the other hand, their portfolio has increased, their market size has increased.
Okay, Mr. Sinha, as I began by saying this, what are the advantages of companies like yours which are involved in the wide area of products? You're also into paints, you're also into chemicals, you're also into lubricants, real estate, all kinds of things. So what kind of advantage do you get in having so many, you know, As I said
that these are all what you are saying, except of course Liu and Mol. The chemical is a coating, it's a protective coating. It's electroplating chemicals.
Correct.
Paint is also a protective coating. Today, when a object OEM object is painted, there are many things which are electroplated, like your car. Some may be electroplating, some may be the paint.
Right.
So if I offer both the things under one roof, so I have a better chance of preference with the customer.
You essentially give a package deal.
Yeah.
Right.
It's okay. A package and it is convenient for customer. Ki, look, I have
you
some
don't have to run
electrochemical chromium plating also. I need paint also.
Correct.
So I can go to Grovel and I get both.
Okay, okay.
So it's a concept coming now everywhere, how to reduce the anxiety of the customer, how to improve his efficiency so that he is peaceful. And for that, single window solution is today much preferred. Like in our painting, we sometimes even do the application also. Though we are a manufacturer, but we take application also.
That again is a new trend, isn't it? Paint companies taking up application.
Customer is happy with that. He is willing to pay 5% more for that because his hassles are less.
Yep, absolutely. Absolutely.
See, in any project, paint is just 1%. Today, a 10,000 crore project is going on. Paint is only 100 crore and it's a last priority, last item.
Absolutely.
at that point of time, when he has already completed 99 and he exhausted all his energy, he doesn't want any hassles.
Most of the time, even finance.
Money. He's already exhausted.
Correct.
So he what he unless he painted, because he also knows that his 99% successful work will go waste if paint fails.
Absolutely.
So that is what is visible.
Absolutely.
Chairman of company comes, first thing, his paint is good. Made his day. And the moment he said, kiska paint lagaya itna ganda, so company blacklist ho jayegi.
Absolutely.
So, आज वैसे ही है ना कि जो दिखता है वो तो पहले उसको ठीक करना चाहिए. तो ऑब्वियसली दिस पीपल आर वांटिंग समबडी हु कैन टेक देयर पार्ट ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी एंड डू अ टर्नकी जॉब. दिस इज माई बजट, दिस इज पेंट सिस्टम, प्लीज कंप्लीटेड विद इन दिस बजट. सो ये बजट इज ओके फाइन, अदरवाइज वी निगोशिएट दिस साइड दैट साइड एंड टेक द जॉब. सो ही हैज नो हैसल्स. And then I have my responsibility because application is mine, paint is also mine, so nobody can blame each other. So these are the concepts which are coming up very fast in India, that taking single point responsibility to complete the job.
Actually, you know, one of the real estate developers explained this in a different way when we spoke to them. They said that paint is always one of those last things that happen. After everything else happens, okay, piping, drainage, everything happens. So when you come to that point where you have to paint, usually the deadline is staring. Okay, so we need a paint company or a service that is quick. There is no time to waste, because nowadays even RERA is applicable. So everything has to be within the deadline.
Of course.
And they already wasted a lot of time in construction. So that has to be compensated with quick, exterior paint.
That happens every time with us.
Absolutely.
We tell them, you have taken so many months to decide on painting and now you want to finish it in 15 days. So they do it, and it's a reality, we have to do it. That's why I said, in some places we have modified the system from 4 coat to 1 coat. So instead of 4 days, you take 1 day to finish it.
Okay.
So those are the improvisation we have to do if customer agrees.
Okay. Now, you talked about how how things have changed, got integrated with other functions of interior and exterior paints, as well as other material used. What is the exact USP of Growell in terms of comparison with other paint companies?
See, I will tell you about the paint division, as because I am heading that. And I'm joined this company in 2013.
Okay.
With a 30 crore turnover, and with the help of my team and whatever I felt good strategy should be or USP should be, we have been successful in achieving 175 crore in 8 years time, which is a fairly good success, because our main business is industrial business, where all the competition is from multinationals. The top multinational companies of the world, like Exo, like Hamful, Asian PPG, so all big shots. So we have decided one thing very clearly when we started this in 2013, that I have to achieve customer delight. Means it's not customer satisfaction sufficient. Everybody look at customer satisfaction, that you give me an order, I supply the paint and it's over. You pay me and it's over. No. We have developed a product plus quality first. Our products are benchmarked against international brands, not Indian brands. Because you see, these are all performance oriented coating.
Correct.
And it has to perform. If I give a guarantee of 5 years, it doesn't mean that it should fall after 5 years. It should continue.
Absolutely.
It's
absolutely.
Like a watch. You give a guarantee of 1 year, but watch goes for 12 years, 10 years, 25 years. So that's it. So one is product plus. Second is we help them in application also. As I said, if they require, I take the responsibility of application if you don't have applicators. Third, post-sales service technical service during application is very important, because many companies in India don't give any post sale service. Once the business is over, your money has come, you forget. If there is a problem, they will call. They think like that. But we don't wait for that call.
Right,
post painting,
right.
We go there, we meet them. If there is some touch up, some issues are there which can be repaired then and there, it will not aggravate. So what we have done is, basically I call it, improving customer efficiency per se is very important. For that 1% amount that they have to spend on a project, they should not spend 99% of their time. And speed, quality, technical service, these are our major USP, because industrial paint is not only selling, it's a package, it's a solution. We give them a solution. We said that how you present your company to the customers when there are so many multinationals. So we are into aerospace business also. We make paint for aerospace. So our quality system is accredited with AS9100, which is much superior to ISO 9001 and 14001. I mean, that IS 9100, when he was doing the audit, I was telling him, Baba, kitna pareshan karega aur batao. Bolega, you don't know, ISO 9001 will come piggyback on this. So you, if you do this, all are your accreditations are through. So I like that. Today our manufacturing unit, our R&D unit, our purchase, marketing, everything is audited by AS9100 team. And because of that, we are the only Indian origin paint company to have this. And that makes...
Oh, really?
PPG having, but Asian Paint doesn't have.
Okay, okay.
I mean...
Industrial paints, have it.
So, Asian PPG as a joint venture, they are doing it. PPG products are there. So, we are one of the most preferred supplier in the defense industry today.
Okay.
And I cannot divulge those informations because we have bound by a secrecy agreement. But we have 40 odd products which are approved by DRDO, Defense Research Organization, which goes to all the defense weaponry, including missiles, aircraft, tanks, and still we are developing lot of new products for them, and these are all import substitutes under Make in India initiative. Recently, one of our product, we are very happy because got a runner-up national award.
Oh, really?
So it's a big.
This R&D is here in the same building?
No, it is in Chembur.
Acha.
So there is a huge technical work, research goes into this, which continuously developing the products, improving the product, because your weaponry system is also changing. From ordinary 100 kilometer, now it is going to ballistic missiles. So the distance travel is high. So the entire paint system, everything has to match those. You fire from surface, but it goes inside the water, because the Navy requirement is such. So you have, your paint should also match those requirements. When it flows, it fins get heated, it can damage your circuit inside. The paint on the fin has to be such that no heat transfer happens inside. So there are many technicalities,
parameters.
Of course, DRDO help us in testing, because the testing requirements are huge, costly.
It must be very rigorous also.
It's very rigorous, and it takes a lot of energy, time, patience to develop those products. And I'm happy to say that today we are one of the preferred source. We are sole supplier to some of the weaponry system. Without us, they cannot make those weapons complete.
You know, one of the developers in Bangalore, when I was talking to him about products being used, accessories being used, paints and all that, he said, you know, the best thing that you should always ask a accessories company is, how many developers come back to you to use the same product?
Exactly. So that is why I tell my team, even if you don't sell, but if you sell, don't lose this customer. It's okay if you are not able to sell, but once you sell, you don't lose that customer.
Absolutely, absolutely. So what about the competition that you face from smaller paint companies as well as, you know, foreign players? How do you actually manage all that?
See, incidentally, in these coating, the challenges are different.
Mm-hmm.
The small paint companies are not much into play in these.
In your particular niche?
Industrial high performance coatings.
Okay.
But multinationals, yes. They are the bigger challenge because they have got huge references behind them worldwide.
Industrial paints.
Like I supply paint for refineries, power project, drinking water pipeline. So my product has to be at par with them. That's why, like drinking water project, pipeline, the food grade epoxy. Today, India is building up thousands of kilometers of pipeline for drinking water.
Okay.
As per the current government's program.
Correct.
Like Sony Yojana, then in MP also, Odisha, Tamil Nadu, all states are having this.
Okay.
And multinational company has got international approvals. WRS UK, NSF USA.
Okay.
We got our product
approved,
tested. Mm-hmm. We sent samples, they tested, they approved. Now I'm at par with them.
I see. And when did this happen, sir?
This happens from the beginning only when we launched these
keeps
products.
Keeps happening.
Because there is a 3 years, after every 3 years you have to renew.
Okay.
NSF is very stringent because NSF does testing as well as they do quarterly audit also of the plant. So they check every batch that we have made, they check every raw material that we have used, they see every test, very well stringent NSF. And they even go to the customer end to check the paint drums. Sometimes they take sample from there and do testing. But of course, we are not into those kind of businesses where what we say we don't give. We give genuine product, and because this is a question of health and we are good citizen of India, so we maintain that.
Mr. Sinha, my penultimate question would be about government regulations for paint industry, both industrial as well as the domestic paint industry. What are the changes that you would expect from the government so that it will be a win-win situation for both the paint companies as well as the end user, the project managers, the developers, all of them? Small things which, you know, while in your operations you come across a situation where you think if this policy had been a little different, it would have been a great thing for all of us.
I will answer you in a little bit different way this question.
Okay.
See, while I were talking to you or you have asked me that how the paint industry has changed over a period of time, and I told you all the top quality products have been now available in India. But what percentage of population is using it?
Okay.
People have to afford it. Even if you start from Bombay, South Bombay, and start traveling toward Mira Road and Vasai and Virar, you will know what quality, how the quality is degrading that side because of the cost.
Correct.
Now, how this cost is happening? See, there are many raw materials in the paint which we have to import, like rutile, the main white pigment. India, there is a company, India is making, KMML is a government company which is making, they make good quality, but their production is not sufficient to cater the Indian requirement.
Okay.
So 80% of the rutile comes imported, and there is a 11% custom duty on it. Monomers, resin monomers, many monomers come. Epoxy resin, the raw material, bisphenol, epichlorohydrin, all imported.
Correct.
Though we make in India, but then the raw material is coming from there.
Correct.
And in last 2 years, there is an increase of almost 60% in the price. In the resin, in epoxy.
This is the international price.
Huh?
OK. Okay.
Obviously, if your raw material price is increased, your finished good product in India will increase.
Correct.
Epoxy resin is the backbone of the high performance coating. And product price gone by 60-70%.
You have raised a very good point, sir, but here the point is also that how will you, what is your solution to this? To
see, find government has to promote production of these raw materials in India. Like you make a Make in India program for, I mean, government is doing it, but then paint industry per se may be in the little backside in the mind of the government, because it is still considered possibly by them as a decorative finishes and all that. But it's not, it's protecting national asset.
True.
So if you make those things happen, then it will be affordable. Maybe once today in Mira Road you may not find those product, but after reduction maybe up to Mira Road it is covered. So it's like that. I'm not just joking, Mira Road. I'm just giving you an illustration that income has to be so much that you can afford them. But if you cannot afford, then how will you do it?
Yeah.
So all this good technology can only be useful in India when it is affordable. So make it affordable. Look at the
The paint industry or association of the companies, of paint companies, made any representation to the government in regard to?
Yeah, there is a IPA, you know that, Indian Paint Association, which keep representing these things. Sometimes government here, sometimes it is not, because I feel they have a larger picture in mind to deal with. Paint is may not be in fitting in that picture so significantly. They have got a lot of other things in mind. So maybe someday they will do it.
But then this the problem of imports, so that has been a talked about point for a long time now for paint industry, isn't it?
Of course, you cannot do it, because you have raw material available in India. You can make rutile, but you have to do it as a
so my last question would be about there are reports that real estate is going to have a boom in by 2023. How are paint companies like yours poised for that growth?
I will be very happy if there is a boom, because I have to sell a flat. Anyway, joking. Today, if you say production capacity, almost all the big players have got large capacity planned. Even a company like us, which is a middle level company, we have planned our production threefold already and initiated the construction proceedings.
Okay.
Today we are doing around 175 crore or so. We have already planned how to do 500 crore because of this boom.
Okay.
And we have launched these decorative products recently. Formal launch will take place. We have already started selling it to the institutional buyers. We don't want to go into retail, because that's a different ball game.
Okay.
And we have got very good response, I'm telling you this.
Were you surprised by the boom that is happening? I mean, it started to happen.
It is happening. Even in the COVID period, if you say, first COVID one, where we had almost 3 months of all shut down.
Correct.
But still companies grew by 20%.
Correct.
Paint companies,
the results show it, you know. True.
So demand is still there, but only thing is ki it should be normal for everybody to move around, to spend like it was pre-COVID days. But let's hope it should come fast, so that everything become normal and we all can move around.
Normal and we can move around. Thank you so much, sir, for being with us.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.